Hi guys, welcome back. If you're new here, hi, I'm Debbie. I'm a beauty editor and I'm obsessed with finding the fountain of youth and of course sharing it with you. I've been in the beauty industry for over 15 years now and I'm extremely passionate about skincare. I love researching and digging deep into the ingredients list of different products and formulations to help you understand them and find the best ones for you. I post weekly videos on self-care with an anti-aging focus. So if this is the kind of content that you're interested in, I would highly appreciate if you'll consider subscribing to my channel. As well, don't forget to hit that notification bell so you know exactly when I post my next video. You can also follow me over my Instagram where I post a lot of different content that you're not gonna see here on my YouTube. Today I'm starting a new series on my channel where I will take it back to basics. I will be doing a sequence of videos breaking down the steps of skincare. This is essential information that you need to know in order to learn more about how to properly care for your skin and to know how formulations work so you'll be able to choose the best ones for you. And in order to do that, we really need to determine what's our skin type. Knowing your skin type is important in order to build an effective routine that will keep your skin healthy and to tackle any other skin concerns that you may have with the right products and ingredients. Your skin type depends on different factors, predominantly is genetics, although hormonal stages and imbalances, medicine that you might be taking, the environment, and even the products that you're currently using play a big role on determining how your skin acts and feels. There's four major skin type groups where most people fall into. You have dry, combination, oily, and normal skin types. A good test to find out what your skin type is just to wash your face and do nothing else. Do not apply any other products, just leave it overnight, and the next morning when you wake up, you need to analyze how your skin feels. Let's begin with dry skin. This is the type of skin that produces less sebum. It usually has a thinner lipid layer, which is responsible for protecting the skin against environmental damage and transepidermal water loss, which in few words is the water evaporating through your pores. This skin type tends to feel tight and sometimes it gets to present some roughness, some flakiness. It looks red, sometimes it gets itchy as well, and it just looks dull. For this skin type, we need rich, thick, emollient formulations such as creams, heavy lotions, and facial oils. Therefore, the moisturizing and humectant ingredients such as ceramides, glycerin work wonders for this skin type. It is also important to take into account that dry skin and dehydrated skin are not the same. Dry skin is due to the lack of oils, of lipids, and the dehydrated skin is lack of water. So they're not the same, they're not interchangeable. These are different concepts. Dry skin is a skin type while dehydrated skin is a skin condition. We will be talking about skin conditions later on in my channel, so make sure to hit that notification bell so you don't miss them out. Next we have oily skin. This is the type of skin that overproduces sebum, so you tend to have excess oils, especially on your T-zone and your cheek area. Your skin looks shiny, you present enlarged pores, and you tend to suffer from black and whiteheads. This skin type needs more lightweight, water-based formulations and gel textures. Then we have combination skin. And this is pretty self-explanatory because it is actually a combination of oily skin and dry skin. Usually you have an excess of oils on your T-zone and dryness on your cheek and jawline areas. As well, I believe this is the trickiest skin type to treat because you need to use different products to target the specific areas of your face. And finally, we have the normal skin type, which is the one that is pretty well balanced. This is the type of skin that I have, and I heard so many people saying that, oh, you're so lucky, you have perfect skin, but having normal skin doesn't mean that you have perfect skin. Normal skin tends to get drier with age and also can come accompanied by other skin conditions such as sensitivity, which is my case, dehydration, and could be even acne prone. Now, you heard me talking about sensitive, dehydrated, acne-prone, mature skin, and you're wondering, what about these skin types? These are not really skin types. These ones fall more into the skin concerns category. For example, you can have dry skin and suffer from sensitivity, or normal skin that is acne-prone, and even oily skin that is dehydrated. So what I'm trying to say is that you can fall into a skin type category and still suffer from other skin conditions. We're gonna make sure to talk about this in other skincare videos, so make sure to stay tuned. As I said, skin changes through seasons and with the natural aging process. We don't like to hear it, but it's true. Climate as well tends to change the behavior of your skin. Some people with normal skin like me can develop a more combination skin type during the hotter summer months and get more drier towards the winter. To learn more about how skin changes throughout seasons, I'm gonna leave a very detailed blog post in the description box. And that's it with the first video of the Back to Basics Skincare 101 series. I hope it was helpful and that you guys enjoyed it. If it was like that, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up and to subscribe to my channel for much more. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on my next one. Bye!